This video shows you how to easily get started with a SEGGER J-Trace PRO and test its streaming trace and live analysis capabilities. We'll be using the Cortex-M Trace reference board, which comes with J-Trace PRO. The target device on the board is an STM32F407 Cortex-M4. The board also contains three LEDs for visual feedback and the external debug header with trace pins to connect to it. The project we'll be using runs a simple pre-built application on the reference board. We'll also be using Ozone, SEGGER's debugger software, to get trace data and to visualize it. Tracing with J-Trace PRO does not require any special code or project configuration. Also, we'll be doing this walkthrough in real time, so that you can see that an advanced analysis of a system does not take more than 15 minutes to set up. And now, let's get started. Browse the J-Trace landing page at www.segger.com/jtrace. Scroll down until you see the tutorial project section. Here you find the tutorial walkthrough and all necessary software. First, download the Ozone J-Trace PRO project and save it somewhere on your computer. You also need the Ozone debugger software. Click on the second link and download the installer. Make sure you use the latest J-Link software and documentation pack. You can find the download on the third link. Click the download button and accept the license agreement. Now we have everything we need and can install the software. First, install Ozone. It's a simple click-through setup. We want to create a shortcut on our desktop, but without running Ozone just yet. Next, run the J-Link software installer. The setup guides you through the installation process. The J-Link DLL updater starts up. It can update the J-Link DLLs in the installed software which use it. Click OK to do this. Last, extract the Ozone J-Trace PRO tutorial project. The software is now set up. Now you can connect the J-Trace PRO to your computer and to the reference board. Power the reference board via the mini USB port. Start Ozone and click on Open Existing Project. Browse to the extracted reference project and here you find SEGGER Cortex-M Trace Reference Board.jdebug, which is the Ozone project file for our application. Open it. Open the code profile window, the instruction trace window, the timeline window, and the disassembly window from the view menu. In the source viewer in os-trace-demo.c, set a breakpoint at line 44, BSP toggle LED 0, with a click on the gray dot on the left. Start a debug session with the Start button, or select Debug, Start Debugging from the menu. Ozone starts a debug session and loads the program to the target. The application starts up and breaks at main. Continue to run to our first breakpoint. Now let's have a look at the instruction trace window here on the left. It shows us what has been executed. The last instruction executed is shown at the bottom. We can navigate through the instructions to see what happened on the target before we hit the breakpoint. The source viewer, the disassembly window, and the timeline window are all synchronized with the selected instruction. These instructions are grouped by their source function. We can collapse them to see a source function level backtrace, or expand them to know exactly which C and assembly instructions have been executed. Now, let's have a look at the timeline window here on the bottom. The timeline window visualizes the course of the program's call stack over time. It provides advanced navigation features that allow users to quickly understand relative and absolute call frame sizes and positions, which makes it a great profiling tool as well. For the timestamps, you can choose between instruction count, cycles, or time. Remove the breakpoint and let the application run again. On the board, we can now see the LEDs blink. Right-click in the source viewer and the disassembly window and select execution counters. The source viewer and the disassembly window now show yellow and orange bars. They visualize the code coverage, which is what has actually been executed on the target. Now we can see how often the application has gone through a line or instruction. Move the mouse over a counter to get more information about how often an instruction has been executed or not executed, and to get its load. The trace data is read and analyzed while the application is running, and the counters are updating live. Now let's have a look at the code profile window. It visualizes the code coverage and profiling information by source function or file. Sort by source coverage to check how many lines of each function have been executed. Or sort the functions by instruction coverage. The run count shows how often each function has been called in this debug session. The load gives information about where the time is spent in the application. Here, the OS idle function uses 99% of the CPU time. We can filter out functions which are of no interest. This gives us a distribution of the remaining load across the other functions. Now halt the program execution. In the timeline window, zoom out to get a bird's eye view of your application. You can zoom into any spot you like to see exactly what happened, in which order it happened, and how much time, cycles, or instructions it took, giving you great insight into your application. Now we can export the code coverage and profiling information into a report. Right-click in the code profile window and select Export. We can create a report for the whole application, or for selected modules, or for selected functions. Reports can be generated as a human-readable text report or in CSV format to be further analyzed with spreadsheet tools like Excel. Select the directory to save the report file. We can open it up with a text editor and can see that it is showing the same information as the code profile window. This report could be stored with the documentation of the target system or used as proof of verification. That's it! We got started with J-Trace Pro in less than 15 minutes. Now get your hands on a J-Trace Pro and analyze your target systems yourself. We added the Embedded Studio project and tutorial for you to modify and rebuild. The shown steps can also be done on any Cortex-M device with embedded trace module. If you have any further questions about J-Trace Pro, feel free to visit our website or contact us. J-Trace Pro, the limitless trace probe from SEGGER. Thanks for watching!